today to show them here and see at the city government who's out here today. We're here representing communities and organizations, and even though they're not, many of our members are also not here, we're also representing hundreds more, thousands more who are not here, standing here today. Make some noise if you're from working class communities from all over San Francisco. Make some noise if you are a mother and you took the day off because you felt it was important to be out here. Make some noise if you are a worker here in San Francisco. Community, the youth and children. San Francisco prides itself on being the LGBT trans capital of the nation. Can we hear it for the LGBT queer community?
Today.
porque la visión de los desarrolladores ha hecho que nuestras casas ya cuesten el doble y el triple. ¿Y qué pasó con nuestro salario? Nosotros somos trabajadores. Nosotros hemos sido los inquilinos por muchos años que con nuestra renta hemos pagado esas propiedades, esos terrenos. Por eso tenemos el derecho de exigir que ya basta con todo lo que está pasando.
The surge of evictions in the last 5 years has almost decimated our neighborhood. But we are not going to let this continue. Are we?
No!
We said this is enough.
No!
We are here because we demand that the Land Use Committee vote out of their committee, Eviction Protection 2.0, so that we can have some way to keep our people in their homes. We are done with greedy developers that come into our neighborhood and try to buy us out, try to build development that we could never afford. In our city, rents have tripled, quadrupled, and our wages have stayed the same. We are workers, we are tenants, we have lived in this neighborhood, rented these homes for years. And it's time that we get the respect that we deserve, the respect and the rights for tenants all over the city.
San Francisco, lo hemos pagado y lo hemos construido los que vivimos en San Francisco, y por lo tanto necesitamos protección y exigimos protección de la comisión. Estamos aquí porque sí podemos, compañeros, y lo vamos a lograr. Gracias.
San Francisco. We have built San Francisco, and we deserve to be able to live here. We deserve to be able to work here, and we need the protection that are able to keep us here.
Okay, thank you. Thank
rentals, and that is not okay. That's why we need to fix this law so there's real enforcement, there's a cap on the number of days, so that our neighborhoods do not become Disneyland. Right? So we're saying no place should be listed unless they have registered. The Planning Commission needs to see how these tourists are affecting our communities, and they are devastating our communities. So let's go and vote yes on F. Fix this law. Thank you.
People that are millionaires that have the
we can continue running. I'm also part of the Coalition on Homelessness, and it's an incredible organization, and it's helped thousands be able to get a second chance, be able to find a home again after they lose the homes and the roofs that they have. I'm also part of La Colectiva, which is another incredible organization supporting people, making sure that they're able to keep going. Thank you so much.
Which means
for years to set up the supersized pipe and cut the community out so they don't have to comply with the current zoning. The deal with Warren City was more than double existing zoning in this traditionally working class, diverse community and caused massive evictions and displacement of residents and businesses in the area. If allowed to go through, it will set horrible precedents for the city where developers and planning departments spot zone individual projects, ignore the zoning rules developed for years with community input, and line developers' pockets with huge increases in land value from supersizing their lots. 5M has carved out the public central SOMA plan process and wants to be exempt from the youth and family zone. And we invite you to please stand with us against development for profit. Mayor and Lee, I want you to step down.
We deserve more. We're fine.
and insert new growth guidelines to the city's master plan. The intent was for developers to pay a variety of fees that alleviate extra burdens their presence adds to housing, transportation, and educational facilities. But in practice, the requirement means now that opportunists with money to throw around can develop pretty much as they wish. Isn't that right?
Yeah.
Thus, it is time we return to the guidelines and look at how they impact what's already up. One, that existing neighborhood-serving retail uses be preserved and enhanced, and future opportunities for resident employment in ownership of such businesses enhanced as well. Projects impacted: 5M, Feast on Bryant, Redlick, and Prop I. Monster in the Mission 2. The existing housing and neighborhood character be conserved and protected in order to preserve the cultural and economic diversity of our neighborhood. Projects impacted: 5M, Yerba Buena, Feast on Bryant, Monster in the Mission, Redlick, Prop I, Prop F. The next one, that the city's supply of affordable housing be preserved and enhanced. Monster in the Mission, Feast on Bryant, right on Folsom, 5M, Prop I, Prop F. Look at the list, just keeps on building over and over. And I'll give one more. That a diverse economic base be maintained by protecting our industrial and service sectors from displacement due to commercial office development, that future opportunities for resident employment and ownership in these sectors be enhanced. Redlick, Feast on Bryant, Prop I, and Prop F. We need our officials to exercise more accountability in using them for the advantage of all. Thank you for listening, and keep learning. No peace on Bryant, no monster in the Mission.
No peace on Bryant, no monster in the Mission. No peace on Bryant, no monster in the Mission.
No peace on
Bryant.
Stop the eviction. No peace.
Great. Okay. No peace.
No peace on Bryant.
No monster in the Mission.
No peace on Bryant.
Wait till you hear the whole thing.
We will demo for you.
Demo.
Okay. No peace on Bryant.
No monster in the Mission.
No supersize coma.
Stop the eviction.
No peace on Bryant. No monster in the Mission.
No supersize
coma.
Stop the eviction.
No peace.
Stop the eviction!
No peace!
O'Brien!
No monster in the Mission!
No supersized soma! Stop the eviction!
No peace!
O'Brien!
No monster in the Mission!
No supersized soma!
you must take credit. And all of us, we should all be saying, no responsibility. Every development being proposed here are being passed down also. So no responsibility. That is the name of the game right now in the Planning Commission.
No, no, eviction! No, no, eviction! No, no, eviction! No! to stop the eviction crisis.
We ask the supervisor.
We ask the supervisor. To talk with her colleagues.
Her colleagues on land use.
Her colleagues on land use.
Her colleagues on the board.
Her colleagues on the board.
And let them know.
And let them know. That she supports it.
That she supports
protection.
Thousands
of working class tenants in San Francisco from being evicted.
Thank you.
Pass it down!
is. The Humble Tenant is actually two towers, but they call it one tower, which will only be office space, and it will occupy about 800,000 square feet, which is about 85% office space allocation currently in financial district.
Okay, hold on. I need to get all of that. Entonces, el proyecto que ellos están proponiendo son las alturas, aquí lo que estamos, lo que está en rojo. Así que lo blanco, como hemos dicho, son los límites de alturas actuales. Lo rojo es lo que están queriendo construir. Aquí, este va a ser oficina. Esto va a ser este condominio. Miren cuánto más alto que los edificios que ya existen. Condominios, oficinas. Condominios lujosos. Oficinas lujosas.
So, what in this community, there are about different kinds of government. This development is in a downtown support, meaning it's in transitional, it's not financial district where you see high rise. This is in a zone that is for transitional support for neighborhood, as you are transitioning to a neighborhood.
Entonces, en esta área hay cinco diferentes áreas de zonificación, hay cinco diferentes áreas. Esta área no es el distrito financiero, no es un lugar donde hay muchos edificios super altos, rascacielos, de eso no está aquí. Esta es una vecindad de transición. Estamos migrando de distrito financiero donde sí hay rascacielos hacia una vecindad. Así que las en las alturas bajan.
And it's also in the youth and family zone in Salem Market. This part here is a youth and family, this area here is a youth and family zone, and also in this part. So the red ones are the proposed of height.
Entonces, la otra zona que existe en esta área es una zona de familias y jóvenes. Esto, lo que existe aquí, este edificio está arriba de una zona de familias y jóvenes. Este edificio acá de atrás, que son dos torres, pero le están queriendo decir que es una, también está en una zona de familias y jóvenes.
So, they are building this mixed-use development in a neighborhood, in a residential neighborhood. Along here are already you see two to three types of units residential.
Lo que existe aquí son edificios, los edificios existentes son de dos o tres pisos de edificios residenciales. Y aquí los rojos, todo lo que vemos en rojo, son lo que están tratando de construir. Así que ellos están abogando para que sus edificios vayan más arriba de los límites de las alturas. No por uno o dos o tres pisos, pero como ven aquí, por docenas.
And they're also building or proposing to have open space, which will be shadowed the entire day. And there will be winds coming in this from 11 miles per hour to 24 miles per hour.
Y también están proponiendo zonas abiertas, ¿verdad? Así que vemos que tienen zonas abiertas y verdes. El problema con las zonas abiertas es que van a estar en sombra completa. Todas las zonas abiertas que tienen están en sombra por los edificios que están construyendo. Y también va a haber mucho aire. 11 millas por hora, 12 millas por hora. Esto está creando un nivel de aire que va a afectar todas las áreas abiertas que están tratando de construir.
This building, it will have such a great impact on land value.
neighborhoods, it will go that create it all the way to the Mission. I mean, you already see the luxury development in the Mission. But more office space being built, that means there will be more demand for luxury development.
Entonces, y esto, en esta área ya también estamos viendo muchísimos desalojos, ya hay una crisis de desalojos, las veces siguen subiendo, y esto, si este proyecto pasa, nosotros van a ser peor, va a progresar toda el área, ya lo vemos y ya está ocurriendo en la Misión, y esto solamente nos va a conectar toda la Misión, y no es la manera que queremos conectar, nos va a conectar.
Land work for building
it will get more expensive as the land value goes up. Build affordable housing, it will be more expensive than it was before.
Poder construir vivienda asequible, poder tener terrenos para construir esa vivienda asequible, poder comprar edificios para que nuestra gente pueda seguir viviendo aquí, va a ser completamente, va a ser imposible, porque todo esta construcción va a crear que todo sea más caro.
Earthquake. That's amazing.
So, because it's being fast track, we have in the Filipino community in Saddle Market, we have proposed the Filipino Social Heritage back in 2008. En el 2008, la comunidad filipina en Soma hizo una propuesta que querían que esa zona fuera un sitio de cultura filipina y que fuera protegida por la ciudad.
But it is being in the back burner for how many years? But this development, they want to approve it by November for the election.
Y esa propuesta que nosotros hicimos en el 2008 para proteger la cultura filipina en esta área, esta propuesta la han estado ensanchando año y año y año, pero esta propuesta, este proyecto, lo quieren pasar antes de noviembre, antes de las elecciones.
So, on September 17th, please come to the Planning Commission to pretty much slow down this process, because this is not going to a committee process at all. What's being done right now is spot zoning.
Environmental impact. But as to where your neighborhood
buildings going to be built. It should be for our families, right? Right? Yeah. You guys love your parents, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And you see your parents are upset. So it will affect on how, you know, our families will be able to live in our neighborhood. And we will see more office people, and there will be more developments that may come up because of the office people coming into our neighborhood. Okay. And it may not be, and it may also affect of how our, of your parents, how our parents,
we know.